ceremonial presentations. Up first is the Downtown Business Association Summer Stroll Update. Sandy Drone, Downtown Business Association. Welcome, Sandy.
All right. Thank you, Mayor Boomgarten and City Council and City Manager for allowing me your time today. So Pluma Street, there's my little thing. Okay, thank you. Okay, so here's Pluma Street Shopping District. And we're going to be talking about today are the summer stroll. And I always talk about this just so that with our association, with our board, and with our community, what is the purpose for the Yuba City Downtown? Our mission is to preserve, promote, encourage, inspire businesses, and to provide safe and clean center for culture, community, life for residents and visitors. The DBA vision statement is to be known as the premier shopping, dining, and entertainment destination for our region. So we are talking about the summer stroll tonight. Here was our committee. So we've got Teresa Smith from Twin City Flooring, who is our event chair, Crystal Martin, who is our Downtown Business Association director or coordinator, and then all of our Scott Sargent from Sutter Brewery, Brian Hopper, Tucker, Yuba City Police Department. I kind of added them because they actually are part of our committee, even though they don't realize they are. So thank you, fire and police. We do have meetings prior to our events. This is our logo that we came out with a couple years ago, so it's been pretty successful, and we've kept that going. Our poster for this year, so how we've solicited, we've had great sponsors. Of course, our big anchor sponsor is the City of Yuba City. We have Sutter County, Yuba County Water Agency, Recology, Aventis, Grange Co-op, or some of the few this year. This was our big agenda. So as you see, there was a lot of activity. We had a DJ on Tea Garden House or Tea Garden Street. We had Lowe's. We partnered with Lowe's, and they did succulents workshop for the kids, which was a free plant that they could do out there. Kids Zone, we had a ton of activities there. Attractions, we brought in a ton of attractions for kids to make it really kid-friendly as well. We hired some bands out of Sacramento, some from San Jose. Am I correct on that, Crystal? Yeah. And some of our locals as well. Center Street, we try to keep that as a local, our local bands. And then, we had the Beer Garden, which we also included Spike Snow Cones this year as well, and Cornhole. Here are some of the pictures from this year. If you look at the left top, that's Fernando's. It's one of our new restaurants that came in during, he started in the beginning of 2020 during COVID, and he's had a really successful time. Some of our vendors and some of the cute activities the kids did. We also had on Center Street, we had a lot of food trucks as well, and you'll see Potato Potato is one of our local food trucks. So we had a lot of activity from Bridge Street to Calusa Avenue. And so that was pretty much a wrap for this year, for 2021. Some of the successes for this year was our first event since COVID started. So 2020, we had no events. And so we were really excited to be able to do something. We had an attendance of about 10,000 with half capacity. We did a lot more spacing this year because of the current situation that we're encountering. We are working hard to have better attractions for the kids and the adults to make it that a completely a community affair. Created community, surrounding communities also came. And this year it was really fun to say that my city manager was there at 2:30 before the event started. So that was really refreshing because we haven't had a city manager in a while to attend. But it was great to see Dave there walking around. It was super hot, wasn't it? Yeah. I think it was like, this was the hottest event since I've taken over or joined the board since 2018. Like, this was the first time we've had a triple digit. So we had no missing children, which was awesome. I didn't realize when we started events that that is something you do have to encounter, and we're lucky that we have the police department there to help us with that. So we increased our coverage post and pre. We actually hired, we have somebody that we hire that helps us with that, because between Crystal and I and all the committee members, we're usually running around taking care of any little hiccups that are happening with our vendors. We also continue to strengthen our partnership with the city and the staff. We met our budget, which was a huge thing. And then as we keep on evolving, we are getting more expertise on our volunteers. So we're getting better at navigating the logistics of a big event. So I wanted to thank that. I don't know if this was not Katie approved picture, but This was at the event, but we wanted to thank, of course, the Yuba City Police Department, Sergeant Hawk, who was his first year working with us with traffic. He did a great job. Katie, of course, and the team. Of course, Yuba City Fire Department, just with logistics, Fire Chief Anderson, Fire Marshal Fries, and the rest of his team. And then, of course, we've got Public Works, who helps us with closing down the streets, so Scott Chandler, Jack McDaniels and his team, and then, of course, Dave Vaughn and the rest of his staff for helping us with any questions or concerns that they had. And then, of course, the biggest is our mayor, Boomgarten, and the city council for your continued support on this event to make our event successful. And then I just thought I would add, because I know we didn't do a lot of events in 2020, but we do have some upcoming fun stuff. So this board is really engaged. We came up with a new DBA logo. We're going to be fine-tuning that and then presenting that back to the city council at some point. We also have been working with Downtown Arches with a design company, and then we've been also working on our own to present to the city some downtown signage just to bring some more visibility down there. You'll look at the sketch behind, and so the rough draft of our logo was on a napkin at a marketing meeting. Usually the best things happen on a napkin, right? And so as you look at the final, that's kind of what we had. We hired a graphic designer, and that's what he came up with from that. And you'll see a lot of those buildings there. We've got the Sutter Theater, which is important, the water tower. And then I think the biggest thing that we encounter for downtown is that people don't know where it's at. And so we put Plymouth Street on that little logo just so people know that that's kind of the anchor for that. And so anyways, the marketing team is still fine-tuning that, but that's going to be at some point we'll be presenting that to the council to see if they enjoy it and if they have any questions or critiques. And then also Downtown Arches, we're working with a company that we were hoping to work with the city on some options. I know that the biggest thing that we have is especially on Bridge Street. Nobody knows that there is a downtown right there, and so these were some fun designs. These are all elementary kind of ideas, but it was just kind of fun to kind of see what we could do more down there bring more visibility down there. And then that's it. Any questions from the council?
Open it up to my colleagues first. Anybody?
No questions?
I do.
Yes, Mayor Boomgarten.
First, I would like to say thank you for what you do. You and your staff and the members here do for downtown. I think downtown has been a long-standing partner with the city of Yuba City. It's nice to see the energy reinvigorating down there. We got the Sutter Theater. Where's David? You know, we got some really exciting things going on, and look forward to what you and the rest of your board and the rest of the businesses down there bring. The question would be, maybe just give us a little glimpse into what you've got coming up in the next few months that we might be able to take part in.
Okay. So we are doing some kind of October thing with Sutter Brewery. They're still in the works on that. So we're going to do some kind of October Saturday weekend event. And then also we still have our Christmas stroll, which we always do the second Saturday of the month. And then we are partnering, there's in discussions of maybe the parade, the Marysville parade. We've always agreed with Marysville that we would not do events on the same weekend. And so, but what they've presented to the downtown, and we were looking for the city, I think they reached out to the city. Carrie Hawk is as the coordinator for that, is maybe bringing that parade at the end down on Plymouth Street as well. And so those are some of the big activities that we have coming up. And so, and of course, because of the sensitivity to COVID, we're, you know, kind of navigating through how we release that and if, you know, if it's a safe opportunity to do that. But yeah, tons of stuff. We are ready.
Good. I think we are too. All right. Anything from the public? All right. Thank you.
Well, thank you.
Appreciate the presentation.
Yeah.